This video, I'm going to lead you through building the managed staff PDL screen. And this screen allows us to interact with the database and update and manage data in our staff table in our production defect tracking database. This allows you to insert, update, and delete data into this table. We're using a web browser object to view the contents of the table. So we're going to call the build HTML script. And we'll go through that as well. So let's go ahead and get started. I'll just close this out. Now first, we need to go to WinCC Explorer and open up Tag Management. And if you haven't done so, open Tag Management and just create a group. And we need to create these staff tags. These tags allow us to enter data from the user interface. So when we insert or update data, we can enter in first name, last name, and role ID. The staff selected ID is going to be the primary key of the record that we're going to use to update or delete records. We always like to use a primary key. So go ahead and create these four tags. Make sure you create the correct data type. So first name and last name are going to be a string, so we'll use a 16-bit text tag. Our role ID is unsigned 8-bit. You could also use 16-bit unsigned. And then the selected staff ID is also going to be unsigned 16-bit value. So go ahead and create these. Next, we're going to go to WinCC Explorer, open up the VBS editor, and we're going to right-click and do a new project module. I am going to open up the SQL functions.txt, which is part of this assignment, and just select all, control A, and then control C to copy. And then I am just going to make this a blank document, paste this in, and hit save. And we're going to save this as SQL functions.bmo. Then we can clear the tab and press the plus button, and you can see that we have our SQL functions that we can use in our staff management screen. Next, we'll go back to Graphics Designer, and we're going to create a new screen. The first thing I'm going to do is just hit save, and I am just going to call this Manage Staff. And then our properties window is down here, and if you select the screen, this is the properties of the screen. And so I'm just going to kind of eyeball the size here. I'll do 760 by 430. We may end up changing this as we add elements. And then under effects, I'm going to turn off the global color scheme. So first, I'm just going to add the components on the screen. So we'll start with static text. And I'm just going to kind of lay this out. I'll turn off my global color scheme, give it a color, type in some text. So this is going to say manage staff. And then we need to configure it to look the way that we want. And so I'll set my font to about 28, and we're going to change the font color to white. And then under our font property, so notice that my static text is selected, so the properties reflects the properties of this object. Under font, I'm going to set my alignment centered, and then I'm going to turn on bold, and maybe make this a little bit bigger. There we go. I think that looks good. Now to get the 3D effect that we had in the others, I'm just going to add a rectangle to the screen, and then I will turn off the global color scheme, and then I will select this manage staff, hold my shift key down, select this one, and make them the same size. And then I'll turn this black, and then I'm using my arrow keys to move this up, and then I'll right click and do order objects, send to back, and then it's still selected, so I'll just kind of move it where I want. We can use the same procedure to create the other static labels. Here, this is our first name label. And we can just highlight this and use our eyedroppers to copy the properties and then paste the properties in here. And we're going to make this a font size of about 18. We can use the same procedure to create the remaining static text objects that we have. And I'll just click save. Next, we're going to add our tags. I'll just make this first name label the same size as my last name label. And then we're going to go to our tag browser down here. And under script tags, I'll just drag these tags where they're appropriate here. So that's going to be my last name tag. This is going to be my first name. And then the role ID is going to go here. And the selected ID is going to go right here. And then I'm going to copy the properties out of this and paste it into these. I'm holding the control key down and I'm going to paste them in, but then I'm going to turn it back white and make the font black. And then we're just going to size these. So I will use my sizing, justify these up. I'll do the same for this. Same height, same width, left justify. And so I'll size this guy here, left justify. Maybe make this a little higher. And I'm going to use my arrow keys to just kind of place these where I want them. And then for my selected staff ID, we're just going to make it the same size here. And then it looks like all this stuff needs to come up some, so we've got room for our buttons. I'm going to go ahead and save. And then on the controls palette, I'm going to grab the WinCC web browser control, the Chromium version, and just kind of place it right here. I will turn off the window title and just click OK. And actually, I'll double click it. And we're going to turn off our toolbar and status bar here. Hit save again. And then on our web browser, I'm just going to name this web browser, just to give it a name that we can reference in a script. Then I'm going to go back to the standard palette here, grab the combo box, just put this here, use my arrow keys, and we have to configure this. I'm going to make the font same as the others, 18, and that one looks like it's got the bold on, so I'm going to turn that off. And the way you configure this combo box is, first, you go to geometry. We only need three rows because this is our roles, operator, repairman, and supervisor. Then we're going to go to font, and the index and the text properties work together. And so for index one, in the database, that correlates to an operator. So I will just make the text for index one say operator, and then I'm going to change this to a two. This is going to be repairman. And then I'll change this to a three, and this is going to be supervisor, and we'll just hit save. And then I'm just going to size this. Actually, I think I used font 20 on this. And then there's a couple of things that we need to do here. Number one, if we go down to miscellaneous, the selected box, this is the box that is selected, and we want to tie that back to our role ID so that when they select a role, it goes in the tag, and then if we refresh this page, the tag should drive what text is selected. So I'll just right click here and choose tag. And this is going to be our role ID. And I'll make it a quick update cycle here, 500 milliseconds. The other thing we want to do is when they select something different here, we need to have it right to this tag. So I'm on the events tab. We're going to go to property topics under miscellaneous, and there is a selected box change, and that's the event that fires when you make a different selection. I'm just going to right click and do a direct connection here and just say, okay, whatever you select, it's going to go directly into our staff role ID tag, and we'll hit save. So finally, we're going to add our buttons. They're under Windows Objects on the Standard tab. I am just going to grab a button here, and this is going to be Insert. I will size it here. I think it was green. We have to turn off our global color effects for the color to take effect. And we're going to set the font here to 20, and we'll make it white color here. And then I'm just going to right-click and duplicate this. Maybe make this a little smaller. My font here is going to be update, and I'll duplicate that again. This is going to be our delete button, and it's going to be red, and this one was blue, and I'll hit save. And I'm just going to lasso these objects here and just kind of move them up a little bit, give these buttons a little bit more room. And now we'll copy the scripts on these buttons. So I will select my insert button, go to the events tab, and I like to use the release left event, and we'll do a VBS action. And I will paste in the code from the assignment. And we just need to make sure that our web browser here is named exactly the same as the web browser object or the script is not going to find it. Starts with a lowercase w web browser. If I just click OK and go back to this web browser, we can see it is the same, so this script should work. We'll do the same to our update button. I'll go to the events tab, and I've copied my update code from the assignment, and I'm just going to paste it in here in this window. And again, we just check this, that looks good, and I'll click OK. And finally, we'll do our delete button, and I've copied the code for the delete command, new VBS action here, and I will paste in the code and click OK and save. And we also have the screen itself. We have the event code that initially loads our browser. So I've copied that as well, and you just select the page, just click in an empty space, go to events, and then on the open picture event, we'll do a VBS action and just paste in the code and just click OK and save. And now we're ready to test in runtime. So when runtime, our table loads into our browser, that's a great sign. We're going to try to insert a record here. So I'll just put in Andy Rooney, and we'll make Andy a repairman. So it should write 2 into there, or if I put in operator, it should write 1. And we'll just hit insert, and we do see him added down here. And then if we want to update it, we'll just add that back. I think in the next assignment, we're going to put a load button so that when we put in an ID here, it loads in the information. And let's say that we misspelled the name and there's no E in it. Put 34 here, and we'll hit update, and we'll verify, and it does update the record. And then, of course, we could put 34 in again, hit delete. Verify that we're going to delete it, and the record goes away. So our managed staff table is working correctly.